you know, kind of neglected that. I'm gonna show you something else. When we draw the body, we tend to figure out that the torso, if it is divided in four segments, the first head segment is for the head, and then the other three is for the torso, including the neck. The first thing I do is I'm gonna draw a heart at the bottom on the fourth division, which is the crotch. So that's for you, that's here. And I do a heart here. And that's, I'm gonna draw the heart, but I'm not gonna cut the heart. But I'm gonna draw the heart for you to understand. Hopefully some of you understand that. So instead of drawing the heart, I'm gonna cut it in a block shape, you know, like same thing as I did the head. And I'm gonna take it away. So I take away two of the pieces, and all of a sudden I have this. I have this shape, okay? By the way, this is so logic or simple that it becomes very difficult for almost everybody. And of course, this is, I'm not saying it because you know, I teach this thing, but since ancient times, you know, like 4,000, 6,000 BC, they tried to do the same thing and have the same problem. A long time ago, right? So then they say, okay, how long is her neck? Well, or I don't know, maybe close to one half of her head length, or a little shorter, to whatever you want the head to be, how long the neck to be. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut the length of the neck, so I remove the clay, throw on this thing here. So two more pieces off. And those two more pieces off to give you the length of the neck. So you got the neck, see, got the neck. If you want a longer neck, it's your choice, not my choice. So whatever I do. Then after that, if you, I don't know if I have the whole thing, oh, this is a bit there. On the skeleton, what I'm doing is on the skeleton. So whatever I'm doing is in the skeleton there. So I do my oranges. Remember what the oranges are? Yeah, around here, so that would be where you have what's called tire, fat, whatever you want to call it, or curve, whatever. And some of you have a different curve, some of you have fat. Then on top of that, I want to create the shape of the diamond and try to eat your heart. And so the oranges stop that shape from being the heart. I'm just going to draw it for those of you that do not understand what I'm talking about. That's why I have to draw it. Okay, so this is Mr. Pac-Man. I'm gonna do the eye too. This is Mr. Pac-Man. For those of you who do not understand, this is the drawing right here. See? Okay, it's super simple. But this is what it means is the logic of this. Super simple. And anybody, even a six-year-old, can do this if I keep it, you know, interesting. I don't know about that. Anyway, so what I do, I cut the outside of the Pac-Man, or that egg shape, whatever you want to call that. And I got two more pieces. It's almost like whatever I cut on the left, I cut on the right. So I got two other sets of pieces. And voila, I got half of the body. This is your torso. So I got the half of the body figured out. And of course, you're doing a tamal or the burrito technique. It is a little different, but I have what you need to do it. Now, the rest of the lower part of the body are legs. Look. This is the thing. Ta-da. See? Standing up, and you can sit down. Sit down. Sit. Okay. Six. Well, it's up to you. Okay, whatever you want. Now, for the legs, I already prepared the same length and the same amount of clay that I'm going to put in here. See? I'm going to go for the lower part. Okay, so that's the lower part. It's supposed to be, in general, forehead length. But I'm gonna cut it. Then the question is, how wide? Well, depending, you have saddle bags or whatever. Well, depending on the width of the model's legs. So So what I do, I just kind of draw the part of the candle that you're supposed to learn how to draw. Next time that I teach this issue, if I teach light drawing, I'll let you know. Okay. And the two head down, you have the knee area. So two head down or two head up, you have the knee area. Two heads up or down, whichever from the crotch.
These U's that you brought down, are those your heart, from your heart?
The crotch is already covered. The crotch is already a part of the torso, where I've been doing it just today. The legs are also being divided in the fourth.
Those
are the cantaloupes. The cantaloupes, of course, oh my God, some of you rolled your eyes, okay, fine. Don't roll it too much because they're going to stay like that. That's the width of your leg. The width of your leg. So what do? I'm going to cut the leg without taking it. I'm just going to do it like I have the width of the leg, and the width of the leg on top is like this. So this leg, according to the cantaloupe, is this one, right? But only the top. According to the cantaloupe, a part of the cantaloupe I drew is this wide, right? Get it? Okay. This works because it's in 3D. So, but my leg is not that fat at the bottom unless you have a leg on chassis. That's the disease that make your leg really like an elephant leg. That's part of life, you know. Anyway, so there we go. I do the same thing for the other leg, so I take away the other same amount of leg. Out of here, same size. And then I have to kind of figure out where the knee area is. The second head down, it gives you, you can draw a nice, beautiful grapefruit, one of those, depending how fat your knees look, that would be the size of the grapefruit. How wide is the grapefruit? So it will be. That's what I'll tell you, how I do this stuff, okay? By the way, this is 3D. We are not just drawing it. This is although I'm making lines, but this is for you to understand the structure that you need. So this is the knee. Nice, beautiful, grapefruit. So what the grapefruit will do? Well, the grapefruit tell you that the cantaloupe on top is wide, and then the leg is going to taper because of the grapefruit being a little thinner, less wide, and it's going to show you the shape of the leg. So I'm going to cut here, and then I'm going to show you one leg at a time. So I cut from the top of the grapefruit to the cantaloupe to the grapefruit, and then taper the leg. Look, this is some of you get hard time because I don't know, kind of simplified. See, wider on top. Narrow the bottom. Most of you will tell me, I already know that, and why you have big fat legs. Not you, the picture. You know. Then what do? I continue down and I find the ankle bone. So the ankle bone is represented by 11. So what I'm going to do, I kind of draw a small circle about the size of the lemon, the relationship to the leg. Lemon, very simple. Lemon. You know, everybody put lemon? And somebody does. I don't want lemon. If you put a cantaloupe at the bottom, you have a really sore leg or inflated leg. And what I'm going to do is kind of cut the shape from the grapefruit to the lemon. And then also that will help me taper the leg one more time. So let me do both at the same time since I already drew them. And I show you both legs at the same time. I have two legs. If I have the same width of my grapefruit, the same width of my cantaloupe, I have legs that would be about this wide in the front. concrete is thicker leg, wider on top, narrow at the bottom. Wider on top, narrow at the bottom, all the way to the ankle bone, that would be really sense. Of course, the rest of the story is your foot, and then you can come out with a foot like that. So what happens here? Well, I come back and I add my torso, and guess what? I add the body. From this body, what I can continue adding, subtracting, and moving. So what, in reality, when the body is sitting, it kind of loses, depending on how you sit, and you sit like this, then it's not four heads. Oh, come on, make it straight up, and that will be four legs. So let's say this guy is sitting like this. This person or thing is sitting like this, okay? What's gonna happen to the leg? What are you gonna do with the legs? Of course, the leg on the side are not this bad. It's all, they're tapered the same as, similar to the front. So what do? Taper the leg. From the cantaloupe to your lemon. And of course, some of you are still in limbo. I don't know what, if you know what I'm talking about. That's okay. Eventually you get it. So the front of the leg, the back of the leg, see? Just by taking your time and doing this. Of course, some of you say, yeah, I don't want to make it solid. Well, you make the pieces that you need, but think about what I'm doing here. So I'm going to show you the same leg, I mean the other leg, that would be as fat as the other one. So what happens if you cut them like this, they both are the same size and same thickness. And I know some of you that do these structures, one leg is fatter than the other one, shorter than the other one. So what does this help me with? Well, I want to apply this idea to my sculpture. What are you talking about? Well, why don't you connect your legs? There. Connect your legs to your torso. Because you forgot that the cantaloupe is part of the torso, you put it in front instead of melting it together. So what I'm gonna do is kind of make it disappear, and I'm gonna bring it in. So the length of the legs are not, you know, hard to cut. It's easier. You cut the size of your cantaloupe. And then that will give you the proportion of the legs. Let me show you. Remember when I made the legs, I drew the cantaloupe? Cut that section, and that will give you the proportion.
Is that what the fish is sitting on?
Yes, it's sitting on, and the cantaloupe is part of the torso as well. There you go. So I got the legs a lot shorter, a little more realistic looking. Okay. And then you can open the legs or whatever. So that's the kind of gist of all this. And of course, when you look at the head, and the head is really fat, but also the neck is really fat. And what you do is kind of do the shape of the neck, cut out some of the clay, and then you get your neck going here. See? That's the beginning of that. So in about 10 minutes, I have this guy going. And then, of course, I had to see it in something else. But at the same time, you will be able to say, oh, well, here, there's a leg cross or whatever. And then you can work on it. Any questions?